In this video and the videos that follow, we're going to talk about three ways to build new vector spaces out of old vector spaces. The first one of these is called the external direct sum. And let's suppose that W1 is a vector space and W2 is another vector space. They can have nothing to do with each other. Maybe W1 is the space of all 3x3 matrices, and W2 is the space of all fifth-order polynomials. They can be absolutely anything. Now, the direct sum, the external direct sum, which is written like this, we put a plus sign inside of a circle, is a new vector space, which this is a space of all ordered pairs. All ordered pairs W1, W2, such that little W1 is in the first vector space, and little W2 is in the second vector space. Now that's what it is as a set. To have it as a vector space, I've got to tell you what it means to add two vectors, and what it means to multiply them by scalars. But that's really pretty straightforward. If I give you W1, W2 plus, let's call it W1 prime, W2 prime. And I guess I should put arrows on these to show that they're vectors. Then you just add each term separately. And basically, what's happening in the first entry and what's happening in the second entry just don't talk to each other at all. Likewise, if you want to multiply W1, W2 by a scalar, you just multiply the first guy by the scalar, you multiply the second guy by the scalar. And of course, you've seen this before. If W1 is R and W2 is R, then this is just R2. And it slightly more generally, if W1 is Rn and W2 is Rm, then W1 direct sum W2 is just Rn plus m. All we're doing is you're writing the first n coordinates up there, and then you write the next m coordinates down there. And you play with them separately like that. So that's the external direct sum. Now, one thing about the external direct sum is that the dimensions add. So let's suppose that we have a basis for W1, and let's have another basis, I'll call it D, D1 through Dm is a basis for W2. So these live in totally different spaces. These are vectors in W1, these are vectors in W2. It's a basis for W1, it's a basis for W2. Now, these vectors are not in the direct sum, and neither are these. However, you could have a vector B1 followed by a 0. That's in the direct sum, because a direct sum is an ordered pair, something in W1 and something in W2. So you can take all those basis vectors and just pad them with zeros. And then you can take all the other basis vectors and pad them with zeros on the top. And I claim that this is a basis for the direct sum. In particular, this means that the dimension of the direct sum is the dimension of W1 plus the dimension of W2. Okay, so that's how big the direct sum is. Last point about the internal direct sum is, once again, W1 does not sit inside the direct sum, neither does W2. It's tempting to draw a picture of the direct sum and to draw it like this, and to say W1 and W2. But that's not right. Because W1 and W2, they're totally different spaces. They don't live in the same place. However, what you do have is all of the vectors of the form whose second coordinate are 0. And you can think of that as being like a copy of W1. This is, you know, the vectors of this form do form a subspace of the direct sum. And vectors of this form form another subspace. And these are the two subspaces that sit inside of the direct sum. So it's not W1 and W2, it's padded W1 and padded W2. Now, in the next video, we're going to talk about a construction where you look at two subspaces within a space and build what's called the internal direct sum.